Good evening, ma'am. Thank you so much for a very wonderful and informative session.
Shall Thank you so much. With our, I hope I would be informative, and if I can be useful to anybody, it would be more than good for me. Yes. Though my throat is a little bit not working, still I try to manage.
No, ma'am. You were excellent. I think our viewers loved it, and they have quite a few questions for you. So, with yes. your permission, we can proceed with our question and answer round.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
So, the first question that our viewer has is that why is the matrimonial law in favor of the wife? Does the law equally apply to both women and men? So, yeah.
It is actually not a question. It is basically a debatable topic.
Right.
क्योंकि generally ये हर कोई पूछना चाहता है कि कि बेसिकली कि आप लॉ फेवरिंग वुमेन और नॉट. ऑफ कोर्स वी कैन नॉट से दैट वुमेन फेवरिंग लॉज हैं, बट यस ऑफ कोर्स वी आर नॉट रीच दैट स्टेज टुडे देयर वेयर वी कैन आस्क द वुमेन विदाउट हैविंग एनी सिक्योरिटी. सो वी इन राइट नाउ वी हैव नॉट रीच दैट स्टेट जहां पे हमें लॉ फेवरिंग वुमेन्स आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. सो वी स्टिल आर मूविंग towards that direction where we have a gender equality or we have a equality equal laws, but still we have not reached that stage today. But there are some judgments also which are coming regularly to the way that they are also protecting men's right. Like I told just in my session that there was a judgment of Supreme Court last year which says that there should not be an immediate arrest in 498A because of the misuse of 498A. So we cannot exactly say that there is a law only favoring women. There also there was a judgment which came in 2000. Just I said in my session, which came in 2018 on Benami Act. There was a huge. It was a judgment which was there in Manoj Arora versus Mamta Arora, जो वाल्मीकि मेहता जी ने दिया, जिसमें कि ये बोला गया है कि अगर वुमेन के नाम पे भी जमीन ली गई है, वाइफ के नाम पे यू हैव परचेज्ड अ प्रॉपर्टी, बट यू हैव डेफिनेट सोर्सेस टू शो दैट द प्रॉपर्टी वाज बीइंग परचेज्ड आउट ऑफ योर ओन इनकम एंड सोर्सेस, देन इट कैन नॉट कम अंडर बेनामी ट्रांजैक्शन. यू कैन क्लेम योर ओनरशिप,
राइट?
यू हैव बीन क्लेम टू नो. सो ये तो मैन फेवरिंग देयर वाज अ, अगर आप इस जजमेंट के बाद आप उसके वो पढ़ोगे व्यूज, सो देयर वाज सो मच रिटन ऑन इट दैट दिस इज अ anti, this bill is anti women, this and that. So it is not that. The society has to be take care and balance with both the things. But yes, I would again say we have not reached that place where women doesn't need security and women doesn't need their legal rights remedies. So they should be, we have to work for that also.
Right. Okay. So the next question is, can a woman who is waived off her right of maintenance or alimony because she was at the time of divorce financially stable, can she claim that maintenance and alimony after the divorce has been granted and she loses her job and she's not financially stable but still continues to be unmarried?
Look, when it comes to mutual consent, you have to consider all the aspects, whether it's custody, whether it's alimony and everything. If you have taken all the aspects and you have counted on that particular aspects and you have given your statement on oath, of course you cannot claim maintenance. But yes, I would say again, there are judgments which says that they are in favor of that also, that women can claim maintenance even after divorce, but not basically for mutual consent. Yeah, if she has got the one-sided divorce where she is not being granted maintenance, and then she can claim for it. But if it comes to mutual consent, then it is difficult. You cannot go in an appeal or you cannot go against the order when you have yourself signed it.
Right.
Your statement has been recorded. Court has asked you. You have been given time, 6 months time to think about it. So it's difficult.
Thank you, ma'am. So one of the questions is, pre-litigation mediation a good idea for matrimonial disputes?
Very good. It's a very good idea. You can move to the courts of mediation center of the Delhi High Court which provides this opportunity that you can get the your case filed in the pre-litigation mediation center. The pre-litigation mediation center will file the will issue the notice to the other party and will try to mediate the parties, which they will be doing it after the case is filed.
Right.
So it's before you end up in losing your money in litigation in courts. So it's better you can approach the other side. And when it comes to lawyer, that ki lawyer kaise kamayega in other ways, if so students are learning ki agar hum pehle hi settle kara denge to aisa kuch nahi hai. Pre-litigation mediations are paid mediations. Client has to pay your fees. Lawyers are allowed in the mediations. In fact, lawyers are being asked to come in the mediations because without a lawyer, the matter is solved. Hote nahi.
Right.
So lawyers are requested to come in the mediations.
So lawyers play a very, very important role in the pre-litigation mediation.
They have to. The mediators ask the lawyers to accompany their clients, and because every time small things have to be discussed, a client is more comfortable with the lawyer only. And even the mediators have their own restrictions. They cannot give their legal opinion. They can only share the something which is have to be mutually or as a neutral party. So that is why lawyers are invited, and they are being necessity for these kinds of mediations.
Okay. So can a divorce be granted only on the ground that the couple is unable to conceive and have a child?
This is not a ground at all in our Hindu Marriage Act. This can be a ground because aap dekho koi aisi problem jo uske haath mein nahi hai, this cannot be ground if you cannot be able, because there are some other methods also. You can get the baby through IVF. You have different modes. Not if you cannot have a baby naturally, you can with the artificial ways, with the medical ways. There are the science has been so much developing. So this cannot be ground for moving for a divorce. Yeah, not having, if you are depriving your partner for a sexual relationship, can be a ground.
Right.
It is a ground. There are judgments which have been speaking on this.
Right. Okay. In your opinion, would a lump sum money as maintenance be a better option as opposed to a monthly maintenance for a wife?
कोर्ट के पास तो वो ऑप्शन है जो आप मांगेंगे. कोर्ट से आप जो मांगेंगे आपको वही मिलेगा. अगर आपने रिलीफ मांगा कि मुझे साथ रहना है तो आपको साथ रहने का रिलीफ मिलेगा. अगर आपका मन करता है 2 महीने बाद कि नहीं मैंने साथ ही रहना, मैंने तो अलग रहना है, तो आपको अपनी पिटीशन विड्रॉ करनी पड़ेगी सेक्शन 9 की, एंड देन यू हैव टू अगेन फाइल पिटीशन फॉर डिवोर्स. इट्स नॉट दैट कि उसी पिटीशन में यू विल आस्क फॉर डिवोर्स. सो इट्स अ वेरी वेल सेटल्ड फैक्ट. Whatever you have asked, you will only get that only. So, अगर आप मेंटली मेंटेनेंस मांग रहे हैं, इंटरिम मेंटेनेंस, मंथली मेंटेनेंस, तो कोर्ट आपको वो ग्रांट करेगी. अगर आप मेंटेनेंस की एप्लीकेशन नहीं लगा रहे इंटरिम, तो कोर्ट नहीं ग्रांट करेगी.
No, if
there was a case where I was arguing, the other party come up on the date, the counsel said कि मैम इनको तो मीडिएशन ही नहीं, इनको तो मेंटेनेंस ही नहीं मिल रहा है, दिस एंड दैट, द अदर पार्टी इज नॉट पेइंग मेंटेनेंस. आई वाज क्वाइट इन लिसनिंग टू द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स ऑफ माय लर्नड फ्रेंड काउंसिल द ऑपोजिट साइड. आई जस्ट सेड वन वर्ड, काइंडली सी देयर पिटीशन, दे हैव नॉट आस्क्ड फॉर इट, व्हाट दे आर क्लेमिंग नाउ. शी वाज आस्किंग फॉर मेंटेनेंस अंडर सेक्शन 24 ऑफ एचएमए फॉर इंटरिम, बट शी हैज नॉट मूव्ड एनी एप्लीकेशन. हाउ कैन कोर्ट कैन ग्रांट इट? सो अगर आप मेंटेनेंस मंथली मांगेंगे तो मंथली मिलेगी, और अगर आप नहीं मांगेंगे तो कुछ नहीं मिलेगा. बट देन क्या बेटर है किसी के लिए? तो ऑफकोर्स अगर आप म्यूचुअल कर रहे हैं तो ऑब्वियसली वन टाइम सेटलमेंट इज ऑलवेज बेटर. आई वुड एडवाइज यू शुड नेवर गो विद मंथली. बट अगर आप वन टाइम सेटलमेंट नहीं कर रहे हैं, आप कोर्ट में लिटिगेशन कर रहे हैं, मेंटेनेंस मांग रहे हैं, तो ऑफकोर्स मंथली हैज टू बी डन.
ओके, आई थिंक थैंक यू. दैट्स बीन एज अ लॉयर, how do we deal with situation where one day a couple says we want to separate, and the other day they said okay, we don't want to separate? I think you had answered this question in your in the previous question also, that they have an option of withdrawing the matter if if they don't wish to proceed with the matter further. So I
see my one answer can give the answer to both the questions, and also in that they can also seek for judicial separation also. If the parties are confused ki we are divorce le nahi le ya saath reh na rahe, they can seek for judicial separation also in that means.
In fact,
baki I would say ki aise clients entertain karoge to thoda sa patiently karna padega.
Yes. In fact, one of our viewers also has a question whether as a client, should you advise judicial separation or divorce? Which one would you advise your client to?
Dekho, it totally depends upon the facts of the case. Every case have a unique facts. ठीक है, आप एक को किसी और पे लागू नहीं कर सकते. Of course, at times you have a similar facts. वहाँ पे you can put the precedents. But it depends upon facts to facts कि किस facts में case में क्या facts हैं. अगर वो facts ऐसे हैं कि बच्चे बड़े हो चुके हैं and woman is herself is well settled financially, then she can move for divorce. And if you think then already she is dependent upon the husband और थोड़ा सा difficult है अभी without family support, तो आप judicial separation के लिए भी जा सकते हैं. But totally depend कि आपके क्या facts हैं. ये टोटल डिफरेंट डिफरेंट प्रोविजंस हैं हमारे एंड दे बोथ प्रोविजन गिव द डिफरेंट रिलीफ टू डिफरेंट क्लाइंट्स. सो टोटली डिपेंड अपॉन देयर ओन इंडिविजुअल प्रॉब्लम्स. एज अ वन वर्ड आई कैन नॉट से कि भैया ये करो तो ज्यादा बेटर रहेगा.
So what are the challenges faced by lawyers in case one of the partners is an NRI? So and how do you determine the jurisdiction in such cases?
Look, in these cases, if you read the Hindu Marriage Act and they have got married as per the Hindu Marriage Act, then there are jurisdictions, a parameter for jurisdiction. One is that where the marriage has been solemnized. So where the marriage has been solemnized can be the case of filing of the case. Then second is where the parties have lastly resided together. So where they have lastly resided together can be a place of jurisdiction. And then the other ground or the provision for the jurisdiction is that where the girl, wife, specifically wife, the lady is residing presently.
Okay.
So these are the three parameters.
All right. Thank you, ma'am. The next question is that one of the question was that why can't an application under section 156(3) be filed instead of filing a writ? In terms of, I don't know in what context was this question asked.
I think they must be asking that aap 156(3) file kar sakte hain agar koi aapka bachcha missing leke. Of course you can, that is an independent proceedings. इट्स नॉट दैट. देखो मैंने क्या कहा, हर चीज अलग रिलीफ देती है. ठीक है, अगर आप सोचो 156 में मुझे ऑर्डर्स मिल जाए कि उसे ढूंढ के निकालो तो जरूरी नहीं है. जो हैबियस कॉर्पस रिट में आपको डायरेक्शंस पास होंगे वो जरूरी उसमें पास हो. ठीक है, सो एवरी एक्ट एवरी लॉ गिव्स अ डिफरेंट इंडिपेंडेंट प्रोसीडिंग्स विद अ डिफरेंट एंड इंडिपेंडेंट रिलीफ्स. डीवी में आप रेजिडेंस क्लेम कर सकते हो, 125 में आप क्लेम करोगे, बट अंडर द रूफ ऑफ मेंटेनेंस, नॉट अ स्पेसिफिक प्रोविजन ऑफ रेजिडेंस.
राइट,
करेक्ट,
या
देयर इज नो स्पेसिफिक प्रोविजंस ऑफ रेजिडेंस अंडर 125. ओनली अ लिविंग एक्सपेंसेस कैन बी क्लेम, मेंटेनेंस कैन बी क्लेम टोटल काउंटिंग, बट नॉट अ सेपरेट रेजिडेंस. यू कैन नॉट आस्क फॉर सेपरेट अकोमोडेशन इन इट. सो दीज आर द, मतलब मेरा ये कहने का मतलब है कि आप अगर किसी भी एक लॉ में जाते हैं तो उसके पास, उसके साथ साथ आपको दूसरे लॉ में भी प्रोविजंस हैं उस रेमेडी को अवेल करने का. सब में हर चीज सब में, अदरवाइज हमने इतने लॉज बने नहीं होते अगर हम एक ही लॉ में सब चीजें मिल जाए. अगर हमें इवन आप अगर प्रेयर भी सेपरेट नहीं लिखेंगे, इफ यू विल नॉट आस्क फॉर इट, इफ यू विल नॉट पुट प्रेयर्स, देन ऑल्सो यू कैन नॉट बी claiming release. You have to ask in prayers. If you have left something, you cannot claim it.
Right. Okay. So in case a false 498A has been filed against the husband, So does the husband first prove the case false before filing a civil or criminal defamation, or how does he go about it?
No, first, if the case has already been has already been decided, he has been acquitted, or if he has not been sentenced and the case has been decided against him, in favoring of him, then in that case, he can move for defamation.
Okay.
Definitely. And even meanwhile also, agar aap uske paas evidence hai ki defamation has taken place, so in meanwhile also he can move. Nobody is stopping you to file cases. Even patrimonial mein to itna cases file hota hai parties ke beech mein ki wo puri bhul jate hai ki kaun si iski kaun si date hai.
Right. How does one deal with the restitution of conjugal right notice?
Notice?
Yeah. Restitution of conjugal right notice for
They have to approach to the court and they have to make their statement that whether they have to live together or not. If they are not ready to live together, court will ask you, then you have to contest the case.
Okay.
And you can seek for mediations. Generally, court refer the matters for mediations patrimonial cases, because there have been directions passed by the superior courts on family courts that they have to send the matters on mediation, and they will try to matter settled between the parties, because I told you it's a family matters, it's a family dispute, so it's always good to get matters settled rather than litigating for years and years, spoiling the life of themselves also and the children also.
Absolutely. We have few more questions on in the comment box. One is,
first tell me, you always have these many questions in every session or only I have been asked with?
Sorry, I lost you there. Sorry, what did you say, ma'am?
I'm saying, first tell me, you have these many questions in every session or only I am the one who is answering all these questions?
I think that you explained all the topics really, really well. So I guess the viewers, we do have quite a few questions after every round, but I think it's
no problem. No problem. No problem. Ask me quickly.
What do we do when a woman filed a case for domestic violence and dowry, but does not want divorce? What are the consequences?
Nothing is a consequence. She'll be torturing more to the husband.
Yeah.
मैं divorce भी नहीं दूँगी, वो cases भी file करूँगी. It's good. आज नहीं तो कल थका के. When she will get a good offer, she might settle it.
Right. Yes. Can I?
But yes, consequences can be that the husband can go and file a divorce.
Right. So I think we left with last few question. Can a decree of judicial separation be revoked by court only, or if the party is cohabited, then can it be automatically revoked?
देखिए, आपने आपस में कुछ भी किया है और आप unless and until आप court नहीं जा रहे हैं, तो who will prove that the relation has ever been happened? See, these are very personal things. If you have had a relation after the judicial separation and if the other party is not revoking, who will testify that the relation has happened also or not? There is no evidence of these. So we cannot say it will revoke automatically. Till the time nobody else is contesting it, if both are free with it, then you are okay with it. If the other party is challenging it for revoking that the matter, the decree has been revoked due to these reasons, then you have to contest it.
Yes. I think with that, we've really crossed our time limit. And thank you so much, ma'am, for patiently answering each and every question. And once again, I'd like to thank you on behalf of the virtual lawyers for taking out your valuable time and being with us this evening.
Thank you so much, and I am also thankful to you and your team, the virtual lawyer, the kind of session and kind of webinars they are arranging, and distinguished personalities are coming in these sessions and giving their views. Because look, this is a never learning process. We are learning till the last breath. सो हो सकता है मेरे एक्सपीरियंस जो मैंने शेयर किए हैं वो इतने ज्यादा ना किसी को अच्छे लगे, या मे बी दे विल फील दैट वी हैव सम अदर रेमेडी ऑल्सो बिकॉज देयर आर माय सीनियर्स ऑल्सो, आई एम ऑल्सो लर्निंग एवरी डे. सो इट इज जस्ट दैट कि वी हैव टू लर्न फ्रॉम ईच अदर, नोबडी कैन बी फुल equipped with all the knowledge. So this is the way we will keep on learning. I have also learned from some other sessions. Maybe somebody has learned from my session. So let us be doing this only. Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you,
ma'am. And thank you. Okay, dear, let me... So shall I log out then?
Yes, ma'am. Can you please save the session and then log yourself out?
Yeah, and one thing more before I end this.
Yes.
That if anybody wants the judgments, they can follow me. And on my Insta page and Facebook page, they can send me message. I will try to answer individually as much as I can. And I will try to provide the list of these judgments also to the virtual lawyer. And you can provide to the viewers if they are seeking for it.
Yes. Fine? Thank you, ma'am. That'd be very, very helpful. Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.